And we're live. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to another exciting episode of Campus Care Ed Talks, an exclusive platform where the stalwarts of education come on board to express their viewpoints on burning topics related to education. Before I begin, let me quickly introduce you to NTAP. We are a 20-year-old IT company engaged in providing mature and futuristic school ERP, CRM, and mobile apps to the top schools across India and help transform them from good schools to the best one. In today's session, we shall discuss with our guest speakers the integration of advanced technology with traditional methods of a school framework. The introduction of new education policy 2020 is going to bring many changes in the educational system. The educators and the students seem to have accepted the drastic change quite positively so far. So today, let's ponder on those things a bit more. For our first guest of the day, he's an outstanding educationist who has dedicated more than 20 years to contribute his skills and knowledge to educate young scholars. Owing to his remarkable contribution, sir was a recipient of Pandit Madan Mohan Vidyalaya Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching by MHRD Government of India. The list goes on. In the year 2019, sir was yet again recognized with Avantika Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Award for Principal, Rashtriya Mahatma Samman 2019. Sir has shared his immense expertise at various schools to promote educational success in students. He's the former principal at Giri Goenka International School, Mayur School and Disha College. And currently, he is the principal of Star Public School, Lumshong. Please welcome Dilip Kumar, sir. Welcome, sir, on board.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you for a nice, big introduction.
Yeah. My humble pleasure, sir. Our next guest of the day is an educator who is the principal of Hame Academy Public School, Hamirpur. Has been profoundly dedicating herself towards the education fraternity for more than a decade now. Ma'am has promoted several new activities and programs to encourage students and teachers. Over the long years, Ma'am received an Endeavour Executive Award from the Australian Government in 2008. Ma'am has been a prime successfully attending various foreign exchange programs, which led her to share her expertise not just in India, but all over the world. Ma'am conceptualized and developed a value education program, Student Empowerment Through Values in Education. Please welcome Himanshu Sharma, ma'am. Welcome on board, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So, dear guests, let's begin our webinar for today. And first thing I'm sure my viewers would love to know about is that the NEP 2020 indicates the need for better teaching and learning methods. So, teacher training with many meaningful exams. Would you like to share your views on the new education policy? Very quickly, Dilip, sir.
Please repeat your question. There is some connection problem. I am not able to hear.
I'm so sorry for the inconvenience, ma'am. I just wanted to know that your viewpoints on NEP 2020 regarding teachers training or some other various teaching and learning methods. Beginning with Dilip, sir.
Dilip, sir? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, you see, it's my list on. It's one of the revolutionary steps which our Honorable Prime Minister took, and this came during pandemic. But pandemic has caused a big threat to the world, and the solution is from India. Not only in the form of vaccine, but in form of a changing education system, which was long awaited. And the government has taken a bold step to introduce this new education policy. Mm. Now, in this new education policy, I will tell you some anecdotes, small anecdotes. I usually visit Cardiff in United Kingdom, Wales. And I am surprised whenever I go there, I see there is no movement of police and people are moving everything. How everything is controlled? later on I came to know that this is the due to technology, everything is being observed. Now recently whatever has happened in Delhi, you have seen. But I see the equal movement there, and everything is monitored with the help of technology. So yes, now if we have to compete and we have to be ahead, and we have to prepare the next generation as per the requirement of 21st century, yes, we will have to adopt, but there are challenges. Because education is, you see, subject, state subject, and being schools in rural and country side, there are a lot of spending, and that we are waiting. The government need to increase the spending on infrastructure. Because there may be in cities and metropolitan cities, you have all sort of infrastructure. But basically this side, whether Android mobile phone is available for all or not. During this pandemic, we started June session. We utilized the maximum. We took help from team. And for teacher training also, there were a lot of sessions which we were expecting earlier. Now, due to this pandemic and due to the technology, teachers are able to participate every month. Every teacher, they are easily available, many courses which we will be talking. So first, this educational, national education policy is a big, bold step by the government of India, and I must, and we must congratulate the government which has offered this. But there are other work they have to do. They have to come up with complete national curriculum framework. On the line with what is in this giant in the document. In order to implement it practically, we will have to, infrastructure wise also, and we will have to, on planning basis also, we need to do a lot. When will we start implementing? That is the another question. When we are going to have the textbook accordingly, or the material resources accordingly. So it's a big step, but implementation side, we have many challenges ahead.
Right. Ma'am, what about you? What are your views?
Well, first of all, I would like to share my views on National Education Policy 2020. Because after a long period of 34 years, we got such a wonderful policy that is calling for complete overhaul of the education system in our country. And the major focus shift which it is going to bring is examination reform. Because it's always said, to bring a change in education system, first of all, we need to change the system of examination. So many policies came before also, but none of them focused so deeply and so specifically on the examination reforms. So in my view, this is a very revolutionary policy. And the striking feature of this national education policy, number one, I would like to quote, is that it will be emphasizing doing away with the rote learning. That is very important. It is focusing on empowering students with 21st century skills, like problem solving, critical thinking, communication skills, collaborative skills. Thirdly, it is focusing on achievement of certain learning outcomes while teaching in the class. So this is something very different than earlier. So the basic nature of the instruction of the teacher is now going to change. This is a consequence of this national education policy, which is likely to happen. The role of the teacher is going to change.
Right.
Teacher is no more the knowledge provider. Knowledge is available in a much better way outside the classroom, outside the textbooks. With the availability of this ICT and internet, knowledge is accessible to everyone. So teacher is not required to explain. Rather, teacher is required to make the child experience the subject matter. So the teacher is required to engage the learner in thinking and problem solving. So altogether, there is going to be a paradigm shift because the examination system has changed. Now the children will be assessed not only for the knowledge, but for the higher order thinking skills. Now to train them for higher order thinking skills, higher order will have to come to the class. That means it is likely to shift, we are likely to have flipped classrooms.
Mm-hmm.
take the knowledge from outside and come and discuss, have a discussion inside the class. Think about the problem, solve the problem, collaborate, communicate, and then you have to face those problems in the examination. See, the latest examination paper of the CBSE, the sample paper, is an example before us. The national education policy has started getting implemented, maybe in parts. So I'm really very happy. I think everybody of us is very happy with this NEP.
Wonderful. And I'm sure there are going to be various, waves that are going to take place with because of NEP as well. So moving forward, ma'am, as an educator yourself, do you think programs such as Deeksha, Swayam will be helpful for teachers?
Well, these portals like Deeksha, Swayam, and one more to mention, Nishtha. These are e-learning platforms which are available to the teachers and students. They have been provided by our government. And I think for the first time, such a comprehensive and exhaustive matter is available. So I have also gone through all these platforms, learned a lot, and I have asked our teachers also to go through that. Even the government, CBSE is recommending that we have to undergo these trainings of Nishtha. So what they are trying to do, I think they are providing a bare minimum standards. Like they are projecting, this has to be the minimum. Maximum, the sky is the limit. But now these standards and the quality in the classroom cannot be compromised. So even like they are making it accessible, equitable to everybody, to the government school teachers as well as to the private school teachers. Lot of resources for students for learning and for teachers for teaching. They are easily available and accessible from anywhere, even from their mobiles. So now what we are required to do? The school heads are required to first of all get convinced about those programs, about their intention of the program, then propagate these platforms amongst the teachers so that they get help from those platforms. And this is a recommendation in the NEP. Now the pedagogy is going to change. There are four stages, 5, 3, 3, and 4. So the pedagogy in every stage is going to change. So the teacher empowerment is required. So it is very essential that the teachers go through those platforms. And that is not the only platform, but at least there is something. Teachers will not be in a position to say, I don't know what is how the art integration is to be done, what is experiential learning, like how to do that. You go and do a course if you are not getting clear. And then another feature of this is like sharing. Sharing of the best practices is not easy. You go to these platforms, you see so many teachers have submitted their best practices over there, how to integrate in primary, how to integrate HOTS in their teaching in the senior secondary level. So such a huge content is available and such a huge useful content is available. And now also if we don't look at it, if we don't use it, I think the very purpose of it will be defeated.
Defeated, absolutely correct, ma'am. So over to you, sir. How do you think, how long will this technological integration be relevant? And, judging by the current scenario, pandemic when it gets over, do you think schools will be so much enthusiastic about technology?
First part of your question, when you talk about how long it will be. Unfortunately, we are product of a system where the B.Ed. or teacher training were almost sold and fit daily were available throughout the country. Now also it's going on everywhere. Wherever you go, you pay a certain amount. In every corner, you will find some university or institution which gives you degree by collecting huge amount of money. But when you talk about Deeksha, Swayam, Aditya Birla Education Center, Microsoft, Google, these training programs are really you need to spend maybe 1 hour to 30 hours, whatever time is there, you sincerely involve yourself and you take a test and you clear the requirement and then you get, it is ongoing in service training sort of time you have to 30 minutes to 1 hour training or 2 hour or 3 hour training. So this is ongoing training, in service training. This is very useful, and this is far better than the degree which we purchase and come enter into the education sector. Unfortunately, that is very unfortunate, but this happens. Because what I see, why this? I see the group of teachers working with me, and they say, I am going to take admission, I am going to take admission from Madhya Pradesh, I am going to take admission from Rohtak, I am going to do BA from Lucknow or Kanpur, like this. And they, after 2 years, means they are doing regular degree course, they are getting regular degree, at the same time they are available, they are in the school. This is happening from, unfortunately, and this previous education secretary also accepted that, yes. So there was a need of change, and being a district training coordinator, appointed by CBSE, I have seen that this is a tremendous, there is effect that everybody is involved. Every month they are sending, and what ma'am has already mentioned you, that yes, now teacher cannot ignore, cannot say that they don't have a skill change, because yes, every training modules are in. So first thing. And then in the field of innovation, AI, a lot of requirement is available with the, even entire is doing a lot of wonderful work, which now they are talking. It was already there. So they started implementing and bringing AI. Now, assessment. Ma'am has also mentioned about the assessment, that you see sample question paper by CBSE. Yes, I do agree that there is, they have started. At the same time, if you remember that you see IIT examination, our examination final stage, or examination in the year 2000 by doctor appeared in examination for Singapore National University admission, and you were allowed to carry whatever textbook, whatever material you want to get, but there is a limit time of 100 question, 100 minutes, you have to finish that. So you don't have. So the question setting, you have to set the question in such a way where you have to apply yourself, you have to focus, and they will take out. So yes, assessment also, there will be changes, but the first phase they have to work is NCF, then they have to, once NCF is there, then they have to phase wise where they start implementing these things. And technology is not requirement of the our subcontinent. It is worldwide phenomena. Now, without technology, you cannot. You have to have. Technology is a weapon. Without this weapon, you cannot win the battle of today's world. So, this is very much required. This is very much practical. This is very much skill based, and this is very much which will empower the generation. So it is ongoing now. It is part and parcel of our life.
Absolutely, sir. Technology is a part and parcel of our life. That's very true. Ma'am, over to you. According to you, do you think these technological advancements will prevent great analog thinking and learning, or it will enhance our thinking?
What is analog thinking? In my view, analog thinking is a kind of procedural thinking. You have to follow a step by step procedure, and then you arrive at a solution of a problem. So this technological innovations, I would say, this is also an outcome of analog thinking. So analog thinking will not be replaced. I don't think analog thinking will continue, and this technological advancements, they are just going to aid or boost or facilitate our analog thinking. So they are going to help us, because see, we have no doubt, we have switched over to smart watches from analog watches, smartphones. So, but after all, we are human beings.
Right.
We are not robots. We are not digits. We are, our basic characteristic of thinking of human brain is analogous only.
Yeah.
So I think no matter how much advancements we are able to make, analog thinking, the importance of analog thinking is going to be there as long as human beings are there, and we are not replaced by the machines.
Right. But my point is, do you think technology will enhance analog thinking, or will it restrict us?
Yeah, because technology has emerged as a tool. It will facilitate. It will provide more opportunities.
equipped
See, now, earlier when we were at the crossroads, we used to ask where to go, how to go, or we used to look at the maps. Now we have GPS. But we can't say if GPS is there, then analog thinking will not be there. Rather, it has helped, improved our analog thinking. So, in a way, technology is not going to replace, the technology is going to enhance, which is you are asking, in my opinion.
So basically,
this is quite thought-provoking question, I would say, or maybe debatable to some extent.
I'll tell you what, ma'am, why I'm a bit skeptical about this as well, because if we move back, let's say a couple of years, and I'm sure both of you will be able to relate to it as well, that nowadays students are allowed to use a calculator, but in my time we weren't. And we used to remember the calculations on tips. We used to do it very quickly. But now, and okay, so let me just paint an example for both of you. Mobile phone aane se pehle, all of you remembered numbers, right? Dilip sir, did you
remember? Yes, yes.
We remembered numbers. Now, do we remember numbers? We don't. Only a few numbers we will remember. Now tell me. So it can play out in both the manners. It might not be necessary that it will enhance our thinking.
It That's can, what I said. It is debatable.
It
yeah,
is very debatable. And you just realized while you were saying, you must have realized ki, okay, this can actually be a scenario, right?
This is what while I was talking to you, I can add to what you are saying. See, if you read a book and if you see a book, sorry, if you watch a movie,
yeah.
If you read a book and if you watch a movie, you are more imaginative when you are reading the book.
Right.
See, where I was going through a jungle like that. So you are imagining a jungle. And when you are watching a movie, the jungle is already there. So you need not. So, of course, to that extent, what you are saying, I will not disagree to what you have told. In a way, like we can say that. सबसाइड तो कर रहा होगा शायद थोड़ा सा रिड्यूस तो हो रहा है लाइक बिल्कुल ठीक आप कह रहे हो आवर पेरेंट्स दे वर वेरी क्विक इन मैथमेटिक्स इन काउंटिंग इन कैलकुलेटिंग वी वर नॉट दैट आवर किड्स आर नॉट एट ऑल एंड नाउ अब तो एक साल उनको मोबाइल्स भी हो गए हैं तो मुझे लगता है टेबल्स का भी खतरा है सो
एंड ऑनेस्टली
वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन
वी
हैव टू थिंक
मोर
ऑन दिस
इफ वी वांट टू पोंडर मोर ऑन इट सो लाइक I don't remember my own mobile number. Sir, wo I accept ki kisi ko yaad nahi hoga. But I will still remember my first landline number.
Right.
That is somehow that. So I guess the shelf life of that analogous thinking and that memory retention has gone down, to be very honest, because everything is so readily available and we are taking everything for granted. I just need to Google it and I'll find it.
But here I would like to add, we have to now see whether we require that information or not.
Yeah.
Which we used to remember. See, right. Einstein also said once there was some anecdote related to Einstein also. He said, even I don't remember my number or whatever like that. So, what is the use of remembering that information that we associate? So, we can say like, we have to see whether we really, really need that information or what is required? Information or the application of the information? We have to use that.
Absolutely.
I don't know. Maybe now.
No, this is also a very good thing. Now, this is also a very good point. Dilip sir, what do you think about this? Do we... Because there's only so much our brain can take, right?
You see, there are two things when we go... This technology cannot come in between. When you talk about emotional quotient and spiritual quotient, these two things are also very important. You see, technology will help us. But it cannot replace our family bonding, emotional touch, and the light and sound which we have within. Now everybody is talking about that, yes, you need to spend some time on meditation, yoga, and on yourself also. Though technology will come, but you see how much time you spend on technology, and then later on you say, no, I need some sort of time for myself. And whatever technology comes, it cannot replace. Yes, I do agree, this is the question of application. This is very important that we need to know. But at the same time, whatever themes you bring, whatever help we take, technological help we take, we have that, we cannot replace teacher, school, bonding, family, emotions, feelings, that aspects will remain. And yes, there are certain things coming, there are certain areas we are lagging. Like you talked about mathematical, we were very fast, and I was just going through international baccalaureate syllabus that mathematics, they teach at three levels. They have higher level, they have standard level, they have mathematical general study. And we are also in India, also we are adopting also, okay, mathematics will be at two levels, we will offer, and slowly, slowly, there are a lot of things we are bringing. But yes, it is convenient that we are associated, we are talking to each other, our students are taking part. Now, see, there is a program run by Government of India, Ek Bharat Shreshtha Bharat. In that program, our state, Meghalaya, is part of Meghalaya, UP, and Arunachal Pradesh. So, someone is from Arunachal Pradesh is approaching us. Some teacher from UP is there approaching us for the exchange program. So, yes, due to the technology, it is very helpful. Our student will come to know about the other's culture and they will come to know about our culture. So yes, for exchange program, making the world smaller, bringing us close,
right.
This is very helpful.
Right.
But at the same time, we have our emotions, we have our spiritual life and emotional person. That is also has to be intact.
Very quickly, I'm going to wrap this up webinar by taking last few comments from you. So, sir spoke about collaboration. One of the things which I know will happen in future because of this pandemic also and because of new education policy is global collaboration. We are going to see some massive collaboration. And I have actually made a platform wherein schools can collaborate with foreign schools. For example, a school was in Bihar and I got them in touch with a school from Denmark. So that is going to be there. Very quickly, Himanshu ma'am, do you think global collaboration will add value?
Of course, this collaboration global level is definitely going to add value because it is going to expose the students to diversity of the culture, diversity of the religion. And this NEP is talking about the sanskars or values. So, and the respect is one value. Respect not only towards others, very important would be self-respect. So when we talk of this global collaboration, we need not impressed by the others only. When there will be collaboration, it will give opportunity to the students to feel proud of their own culture also, because they will be sharing what they have. Like Ek Bharat Shreshtha Bharat, what they are doing. Our Himachal students, they are able to share their culture with Keralites. They are not only appreciating their culture, they are feeling proud of their own culture also. So the greatest advantage of this collaboration would be to just highlight our own values, rooted values which we have forgotten. Our indigenous products, our bamboo, like Himachal is known for bamboo, the students were not aware before program. So Hamirpur is known for bamboo art. So the children could appreciate that. Otherwise, we were only looking at the Western products or the Chinese products. But now, this with the collaboration, the global collaboration, the greatest advantage which I feel would be that it is going to highlight our roots and we are going to appreciate the branches also, the trees also.
Absolutely, ma'am. Sir, what about you? Last thoughts about NEP?
I would love to be part of this type of initiative because it will also give us opportunity for internationalization.
Sir, I'll take care of that, don't worry. I promise you.
And the one thing we have to accept that you see, whatever India is a huge country and technological advancement, they are far ahead. So when our students have opportunity to interact with they will come to know not only about their culture and their way of learning, but advancement of technology which they are using. So we will come to know. Yes, we will talk about our local to global. We have some local things also. A lot of our cultural aspect is also there. So they will also benefit in some way. But for us, it will be a great opportunity. And it will also, we will be able to understand their teaching learning methodology. We will understand the lifestyle. There are a lot of things we are curious about, and we, our student will be very countryside. You see, I am from Meghalaya, not from Shillong. I am in a small village in Lamsalong. So if the children from this village gets an opportunity to interact, so they have not seen India even. See, this is such a huge country here, and we do not have opportunity, thanks to technology, that it gives opportunity to interact with man from Himachal, even from Delhi, and we are thinking even to interact and be part of a global community.
Right.
So it will be a boon for all of us.
Absolutely.
We agree with that, yeah.
Even I agree. I mean, we are covering, what, 2,000, 3,000 kilometers of distance amongst us, right? So, sir,
and we can start from here. I can request ma'am, I would like to invite ma'am to come to Meghalaya, ma'am, or give our opportunity, your student, to
definitely.
Our student to interact with. That will be great, because Himachal is also geographically like lot of similarities are there with the
climate, the north. Yes.
Yes. So, our student would love to speak to your student, and in case you plan. Sir, you plan to visit this site, you are most welcome. We will be the host for you all.
Absolutely,
this,
sir.
This seminar pleasure, has given us an opportunity to collaborate. Yeah. See, you got your answer, I guess.
Exactly, ma'am, exactly. So, global collaboration is going to be the way forward. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Dilip, sir. Thank you so much, Himanshu, ma'am, for giving me your valuable time. And so much... you know, so much knowledge to gain, so much thoughts to ponder. And one thing is for sure, that moving forward, technology will only act as an equipment which will enhance the performance of the teacher. And global collaboration will be the way forward. So thank you everybody for coming on board. Thank you, Dilip sir, once again. Thank you, ma'am, once again, for giving me your valuable time. Thank you everybody on YouTube for watching.
Thank you, Intan, for great work you are doing and giving us opportunity to collaborate. You are bringing us closure and you are becoming a pioneer in this field.
Thank you
and all the best in chat.
Thank you
very much, ma'am, for your time.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. It was a pleasure knowing about you.
We will take it further, ma'am, and
forward. Sure, definitely, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you, Intan.
Thank you, ma'am.